Hey y'all. I haven't spoken about the Rainbow Family in quite some time. Which is good. let all those groups do their thing and without me. And just be me and see what family is still around and wants to talk to me and what family hates me and why, and you know, it's cool. It's been really good. Really good. Here in Tucson, it's mostly old deadheads. They got a ranch where they've gotten this ranch for Debbie Eloy to spend her last days on, and there's a whole mess of folks in and out of there. Sandy Scapegoat's been staying with her. Lynn Meese has been with her. I didn't see Lynn this week, but she's been with her for several weeks at least, since the gem shows. I know most of these people. Lynn and Sandy both have been around since then. There's lots of folks here in town, you know, just mainly old deadhead rainbows. There's a few of the, I don't know. But it's good, strong family here. We get together every week for the 420 show at the Hawk. About half the time most of the time there's something to nibble on, and sometimes there's a big old spread for something or other, birthdays especially. This week was Tom Woolley's 65th birthday. So there was a lot of potluck, and leader of the band, Randy Clayman's, his longtime partner, decided to tie the knot on April Fool's Day. And so there was a huge spread for that. This place has started to pick up. I've got people plugging in. Heidi Banner's been giving me a lot of time. Another one of the transgender sisters here in town. Ariana, another. She's one of. I don't know, Wiccan, or you know, she's one part of that crowd. You know, the earth naturist. I don't know what pagan. I don't know what they call themselves. You know, Happy Beltane or whatever the fuck this they say, Walpurgis, just I don't know. Those European tribals. That's what that is. The European tribalism, revivalists. The Celt, people reviving Celtic tradition and Druid and all that kind of European earth stuff. Which is good. That's what Rainbow is about. It's like the everyone asks, you know, the Rainbow Warrior thing. It's about the indigenous people of the world regaining their roots and throwing off the industrialized society. And it's just like alien shit, dead end. We need to, you know, we have this big society, but we can't be like burning up the earth to do it. that ain't gonna work. You know, we gotta suck our energy from elsewhere. You know, so we don't hurt things. We gotta take the energy from everything, from the living world without hurting it and drilling into it the way we do it hurts it. We probably get our metal from outer space too. There's lots of it out there. But you know, it's like good, strong, vibrant hippie community in Tucson. Lots of bands and lot, you know, everybody's got good following. Plant Jam, Casey Todorito, who I happened to meet through Pantuzzi online. You know, she noticed me talking to Pantuzzi one time and introduced herself. You know, Pantuzzi's one of the people that is still around from my years in Venice. There's very, very few. Jerry Everett, Swami Mami, Garrett. I didn't meet Garrett until Nevada, 1989. And I saw him pretty much every year except the years in the 90s, and since I moved back to Tucson. because of the dam seal. I busted right out in front of the booth. This is my best busking spot during the shows. And thanks again, Garrick. more for the plug than the $25. I mean, the plug was fucking priceless, man. I don't want to get into any of the negativity about the family, because that all works itself out on land. And you know, there's people threatening me, but Garrick reassured me that, like, there's no way that any of these idiots online who are yelling at me, you know, people like Stubbs or Villalobos, or I have no idea what Adam Buxbaum's position is going to be when I show up on the land, but he sure better be fucking respectful, because he's going to get taken down roughly by somebody for being disrespectful. He's going to get dragged away, is what will happen. I mean, that's how they deal with it. I mean, you know, when somebody gets in my face and I won't concede to them imposing their will on me, they get dragged off. Because I'll just shut up and let everybody else deal with it. As at Kevin Hoffman noticed, or whoever the fuck was there, he started a threat. I'll be remembered as the better man, the better person. Puppet man and woman sit. Something's wrong there. My guides are telling me that we're really hermaphroditic species. That Eve thing was reptilian. Sexually dimorphic reptilian fucking our gene pool up. I mean, that could be total boozing. Probably is. But, you know, it's a comfortable thing for my own spirit, being like female in the head and male down there. It's got me through for, well, this is kind of a new thought. this is recently. It's only been the last few years since I determined to come out as I am, I've even, like, been trying to visualize myself with a penis and a vagina, instead of just, like, no penis and the vagina's there. Because, like, this is what my mind's been doing all my life. It's like, I didn't know I wasn't a girl until they, like, started instructing me about how boys have penises and girls have vaginas, and boys only cry when they bleed, and all this other happy shit. And if you need something to cry about, I'll be glad to beat the crap out of you, because you're a boy and you need to take that. You need to man up and all that shit. It's like, yeah, so I did the best I could, to a point. You know, I knew I wasn't allowed to kill anybody, and I really needed to avoid hurting people too, and avoid hurting them, like, with my words. I really had to work hard on my words over the years to keep hurting people, because, like, you know, the thought is there and it wants to express itself, and it's hurtful to some people. And, you know, if I'm going to live by the golden rule, I have to like not be hurting people, because I don't want them hurting me. No, there's no reason for me to go rambling. I just wanted to say hi to the family. Let you know we are going to be bears, I don't want to speak for anybody else yet. There's a number of people that are wanting to go to the gathering that are friends of mine, that will be camping together and arriving together with caravan there. And probably somewhere down the main meadow near Kid Village, you know, somewhere between Kid Village and the main meadow is where I usually was. If I was down, you know, I had a little can, you know, I'd have a little presence somewhere down there, because my main camp was up top in Bus Village, because I was carrying a lot of gear for everybody. But I'm not bringing a whole lot more than likely if I'm staying up north for the summer. But it's not, none of it's coming out. A few little trinkets to give away. You know, if somebody wants to do a deal, they can send me some money and we'll go up there. Or something I want. You know, I mean, that's one of the reasons it got difficult for me. You know, in the 90s, the traveling family was not living on land, except at gathering time. You know, there'd be the annual gathering and there'd be regionals. And it was go in there a couple of weeks before, set it up, stay a few weeks after. And then we're working, you know, we're staying on private land the rest of the year. Usually most of us were working flea markets and fairs and festivals and shit. You know, a lot of, and it was one of the reasons that, you know, they like to have the Western gatherings is because everybody likes to do the Oregon Country Fair in Eugene. I'm really looking forward to this summer and getting back out there. Well, you know, I see a lot of people that, you know, I'm running into people that from years and years ago that are coming through Tucson and saying hi, and people on the web, and then there's the idiots. There are boneheads and rainbows. And those are rainbow heads and rainbows. I'm one of the real rainbow people. I've always been rainbow. Before the first rainbow gathering, I'm one of the rainbow people. I mean, that's what I was born into. My, you know, I'm one, you know, that Noah shit. That's all, you know, my people have been doing the rainbow thing for thousands of years. You know, it's about, are you indigenous or are you industrialized? That's what it comes down to, and I'm one of the indigenous people. And I'm trying to live on the interface. You know, I've always, you know, in my future vision, there's, you know, like these beautiful cities, but also beautiful countryside. So on that, you know, this is I'm a happy day. You know, a happy day. I hope everybody's doing well. You know, I'm praying for everybody's health and well-being and prosperity, and looking forward to seeing people in the summer. Rock and roll. Thanks for watching. Bye.